Finally tonight, a local man is trying to get into the record books one puff at a time. Daryl Leary is attempting to set a world record by blowing up the most balloons in 24 hours. His goal is 7,000 balloons. He kicked off the attempt at 1 o'clock this afternoon.
When people pursue records, like personal records, they build esteem and confidence and they get spiritual progress out of it. And that's part of my true mission in doing this.
Also part of the festivities, this Californian who's trying to break the world record for most push-ups in 24 hours. It's all taking place during the Youth Britannia Youngstown Festival of Hope in West Edmonton.
Richard currently holds that record, doesn't he?
You do?
Yeah. Yeah. Which one would you rather try? To blow 7,000 balloons? Or
not a fan of push-ups. I'll go with the balloons.
You're going to go balloons? Yeah. A lot of hot air, so you might do okay.
Oh! Yeah. Okay.
Two hot airs.
A local man has earned his way into the record books by blowing up thousands of balloons. Daryl Leary managed to blow up 2,501 balloons in just 24 hours, setting a Guinness World Record. His goal was 7,000, but a lip injury slowed him down.
My lungs aren't sore, but what happened was my lips began to swell up really, really bad on me, and it became just literally painful to even like blow up a balloon.
Also setting a record with Charles Servizio from California. He managed to do 7,503 push-ups in 24 hours. That is a record for a competitor over the age of 60.
Here he is. Mr. Charles Servizio.
Yes.
Hi, I'm Daryl Leary. Oh yeah, check this out. And this is the man, Charles Servizio, in the house.
Ready to go
in yeah.
Less than 2 hours. Yeah, it's 11:20, we start at 1.
And how old are you, Charles?
I'm 60, I'll be 61 in less than a month, September 5th, so
and
I'm an old hippie.
And Charles's record for the most push-ups in 24 hours was published in Guinness from 1994 to 1999. And then Guinness decided that was like boring or not exciting enough or something. And they started doing the 1 hour records and this type of thing. Is there like anything you wanna like tell people?
Well, I'm just hoping that things go well.
Justin, what do you want the water to lose?
One thing or another always happens. It seems to go wrong in any attempt, regardless of the organization. And I'm hoping that it'll be minimal and that we go through the 24 hours okay without any mishaps. And that the festival is successful. I hope there's a lot of people show up because it's a community thing and it's a real positive thing for kids.
Yeah, and is there something you would say to people that want to one day achieve a world record or a Guinness World Record or, you know, that type of thing that they should be more aware of?
Well, never take it too seriously, I would say. Train hard, but for the right reasons. Throughout my training, I was teaching, and primarily alternative education at-risk kids, and they were always the priority. So you got to keep your priorities straight. Train hard, but do something worthwhile, something that has a good purpose as your part of your lifestyle.
Yeah, and don't put like all your eggs in like one basket, right? Like, you know, sit there training for 30 years thinking that you're going to have like this glorious day of like fame and glory and...
Oh, no.
You know?
You with something like push-ups or even with the balloons, you might get your name mentioned in a book or two, but that's it. It's not going to bring you much in the way of fame and money or anything like that. You do it because you want to do it. And you do have to, that's why it's so important to have a higher purpose to your life.
And is there anything you'd like to say, like, on behalf of me, Daryl Leary?
Well, I wish you the best. It's going to be tough for the two of us. I mean, I've been through the 24-hour deal to maintain a certain focus. Will be tough at times. You can be very tired, but you know, I really believe I know your dedication, your work ethic. So for that reason, I'm pretty assured that you're going to do at least 7,000 push-ups. No pressure. No pressure. or 7,000 balloons, rather. So I've got a lot of hope for you, and I certainly wish you the best. And also, it's dedicated to your grandmother who passed away yesterday.
Yeah, my grandma passed away yesterday. So this partial tribute to my grandma, to Avi Bastama, I love you. And God, I totally forgot what I was gonna say. I had a reporter come out last night and was talking to me, and he was like, good luck, and like, well, actually I was telling him, right, like, cause it was a short impromptu interview, and I said, the one thing I don't like is when people say good luck, cause like, I straight out don't believe in luck. Like,
I know where you're coming from.
I totally believe, like, do or don't do, like, it's just, luck for what, like,
I guess luck, in the sense that it doesn't start raining or something, but in terms of your own preparation, it's training.
Yeah, I mean, it's...
And your own dedication.
And I mean, like, you were a teacher, right? So, like, that's the thing, like, teachers say good luck on the test, but you know what? It's either you know it or you don't. And if you know it, you don't need luck. And if you don't know it... Exactly.
Multiple choice.
And you're like hella lucky or something, you know. But yeah, so that's it, YouTube. I'm gonna grab some HD shots of Charles here doing like some attempts for like most push-ups in 1 minute during his 24-hour marathon here, and it's. He's going to try to match 3 push-ups for every balloon I blow up, and we're going to submit it to the recordsetter.com, and it's going to be like the most push-ups performed in 24 hours by a senior, being like 60 and over. And that's what I like about recordsetter.com, is that they would be happy to allow us to have an age category, because I mean, Charles isn't 42 anymore.
No.
Yeah, he's 60 now. So yeah. Anyways, I'm out.
Yeah. 53 push-ups in 1 hour, but the current record is 3,877. So I didn't even come close to breaking that record. I'm a teacher by profession. I'm retired now. I've taught. At Juvenile Hall, and I've also taught at other facilities, and I really, really, I've always had a passion for teaching. That more so than push-ups is what my purpose in life has been, and so I'm grateful that I had the opportunity to teach for 30 years. But today, what I plan to do is 3 push-ups for every balloon that Daryl blows up. And if he blows up 7,000 push-ups, which is his goal, I'll be doing 21,000 push-ups over 24 hours. So Daryl is going to give me a good run for the money. So I'm looking forward to it. We're going to have fun. And that's the main thing. We're going to have fun with this thing. And it's a good purpose. And I'm really thrilled to be here.
Well, thanks, mate. Can I just ask just one more question? Just out of curiosity, how does one prepare to do that many push-ups, mate? Do you do stretches, exercises? Do you eat something in particular? Like, just tell us a bit about your regime.
I do push-ups. I don't cross-train. I do sit-ups and squats, but primarily it's push-up after push-up after push-up.
And I've progressed from sets of 10 to sets of 20 to sets of 30. When I broke the world record, they were all in sets of 50. I was doing 20 sets of 50 every hour. And that's just the way I trained, was just doing push-ups.
Well, thanks, mate. And I understand you flew in all the way last night and paid your way to be here with us today. And we're really appreciative, mate. So we want to wish you the best of luck, and we're really going to support you for the next 24 hours. So, guys, ladies and gentlemen, can we just give a massive round of applause for Charles? And it's Savizio. Is that the best way to pronounce? My Australian gets in the way sometimes. Savizio. Let's give Charles Savizio a big round of applause, everyone. And we're going to support him today. Fantastic to meet him. So, 24 hours.
Just point it towards
push-ups, folks. That is some hard work. So we're going to really encourage him and support him. He's going to get started at about 1 o'clock over at the four tents over there near the building. So we're going to support Charles today. But also, Daryl, come on up here, Daryl. Let's can we give a massive round of applause and welcome to Daryl Leary? He's a local man. Daryl, you're a local boy, aren't you?
Yeah, I am.
All right, well, would you like to just give us a bit of an explanation of what you're trying to attempt today?
It's not, I'm going to shoot for 7,000 balloons, but what I really want to impress is that, and if I could talk to the whole world, I'd want the world to know that I had far more failures in life than I ever had successes. And if that's not the case for anybody, then they're not trying hard enough. I think that's what record breaking is about, because things go wrong in record breaking all the time, and it's all those failures that eventually lead up to a success. And I'm just I'm no more special than anybody else. I just live in low income, on disability for social anxieties, depression, you know, really gets in my way a lot. But I love volunteering, and God bless all the people who are volunteering for this. Like, without them, this wouldn't be happening. So that's my thing.
So you're going to be spending the next 24 hours blowing up balloons, mate. And we really want to support you today, Daryl. And we're really thankful for everything you've done, mate. Daryl's had a really important part in even just helping with this festival and being a volunteer at Fusion. And really just want to support. This guy lives in your own backyard. And can we really just support both of these guys today? And before we send them off there and get them prepared to do their thing, we're just going to invite Daryl to just share one more thing.
Last night, my grandma passed away. It's like my darkest hour. I was closer to my grandma than I was to my own parents. So this is my chance to honor her memory and make her proud. Her name was Twavi Bastama, and I love you, Grandma. I'm doing this for you. Thanks.
Thanks, Daryl. Thanks, Mike. Well, let's give these guys a cheer. And thank you both to the both of them. So at 1 o'clock, folks, we want to get over there and we're going to just do a countdown and set them off.
No, thank you, love.
I'm okay, thank you, though.
Paul, I did an elephant with Jamie from Jackson.
I'm tired.
Oh, is that okay? This is great.
Hey,
is the
policy
for this?
It's
just
Trump?
So,
Hey, look who it is. It's world-renowned Guinness World Record push-up legend Charles Servizio.
Where's this one coming from? Oh, you're just videoing that one.
And I'm just some guy blowing up some balloons. Actually, we're at, where are we at right now? 1,513. And my lips are just burning, so that's really a deterrent for me right now. You're about a 5,000, eh?
5,000 something.
Yeah?
I don't know how. I know it's past 1,000.
Okay.
You haven't had any signals.
Oh, here's our hard counters at work. Hey, don't work too hard, eh, guys? Hey, guys. Guys on the couch. Don't work too hard, right? I don't want you straining your backs on that couch. And there's our web stream feed there, right there.
And he says, I would love to try to set a world record for the number of balloons blown up in 24 hours. And Joss and I were going, that is a great idea. Let's do it in our festival. And so way back in about February, we picked this weekend as the time to do this event. And then Daryl started talking about his friend Charles. And they've been friends online and communicating, texting, writing letters back and forth for many years, Daryl. How many years is it?
Since 95.
Since 1995, they've been talking back and forth, and the two of them have set amazing world records. Each of them have set a large number. And then Daryl told us that Charles was willing to come on his own, with his own money, to buy the plane ticket to come to be with us here over the last few days. And so let's give Charles a big cheer for that. And I tell you folks, they have both suffered. I have watched amazing courage from both men in the last 24 hours.